Pyongyang's morning commute begins an hour early these days. Loudspeakers wake people up at 5 a.m. instead of 6. The usual 6-day work week, now 7. North Korea nearing the end of what they call a 70-day battle, preparing for a once-in-a-generation political gathering.
We do best for the building the thriving country.
Hyun Un Mi says she hasn't taken a day off in more than 2 months. She's a full-time tour guide and on a work crew refurbishing Kim Il-sung Stadium, one of countless improvement projects in a 70-day national campaign. Everything we're seeing right now here in Pyongyang is the result of months of work, from the rehearsals for the mass demonstrations that'll take place to the tens of thousands of flowers that are planted along every boulevard. Now that the international media has been invited in, the North Korean government wants to make sure that every detail is picture perfect. Millions of North Koreans acting on orders from their highest authority.
Leader Kim Jong-un is our father, just like our father and just like mother.
The supreme leader wasn't even born when the last party congress happened 36 years ago, but ahead of his own gathering, repeated shows of force, a purported H-bomb test in January, a satellite launch in February, and this submarine missile launch last month, along with 3 apparent mid-range missile test failures, triggering international condemnation and some of the strongest UN sanctions ever. But each successful test also allows the young leader to project power at home, ahead of North Korea's most important political gathering since 1980. 3,000 party members arriving in Pyongyang for Friday's 7th Workers' Party Congress. This reads, Great Party, Motherly Party, and it's one of literally hundreds of political banners that have gone up all over Pyongyang. You can't turn a corner here without a reminder of what's happening this week. Observers believe Kim will use the Congress to consolidate his power and reinforce his plan, defying the international community by continuing to grow his nuclear arsenal, while also trying to grow the North Korean economy despite crippling international sanctions. Many outsiders doubt the two goals are compatible and say they'll only lead to further isolation and hardship. But inside this tightly controlled world, doubt is not an option. All people can do is keep working. Will Ripley, CNN, Pyongyang.